Hey guys, wanted to do a video, and if you caught this video and you are in need of financing for your heating and air system or any other projects around your home, possibly plumbing or electrical, whatever, you can go to our website, newhvacguide.com, scroll all the way to the bottom and click financing, and you can apply. They shop multiple different vendors. They have 0% options and also options with folks with bad credit. We're going to go through a few things that I think have evolved in our industry, because as time has gone on, I don't remember some of these things we're going to go over when I first started out. And I just did a video, definitely check that out, about someone being scammed recently by a heating and air company and one of the tactics they used. We're going to kind of go through. So I just want to start out by saying most companies, heating and air contractors, if they're offering some sort of financing, they're usually doing it through some sort of third-party company. And a lot of times that third-party company, they're going to have fees or some sort of catch. I know there's one particular company that they don't necessarily have dealer fees, but they charge the contractors an annual fee. But some of them have dealer fees, some of them have processing fees, and so on. And I think in our industry, one thing I've always had a problem with is it's kind of become the norm. I'm sure some heating and air guy will probably see this and maybe even comment on my videos, but a lot of them, they're so used to being taken advantage of that they don't even understand that it's a problem. Why is it a problem? Well, if you think about any other industry, let's take the housing market, for example. There are people that are mortgage lenders. That's their job. Their job is to sell mortgages to folks like you and I if we're going to buy a house, and they make money off of that. So they're bringing customers to the loan company or whoever it's through, and they make a salary because of that. Well, in reverse, in our industry, in the heating and air industry, a lot of times we have to pay the company offering loans or financing to you. The heating and air contractors have to pay them to be a part of that. So they don't make anything off of it. They don't stay neutral or third party. They end up having to pay for it in a lot of cases. And so I've always kind of had an issue with that, which is why we are offering that financing option on our website, because in a lot of cases, a lot of times it's you, the homeowner, that ends up paying for it. I'll have folks say, and I've even had people comment on my videos because I've touched on this before, and they'll say something to the effect of, well, that's just the cost of doing business. And I disagree. That's not the cost of doing business, because they're either A, just absorbing it and somehow paying for it through their business, or B, they're charging you, the homeowner, for that. And I just don't think that's right. Now, there are exceptions to that rule. There are companies out there that will do other things that, again, you, the homeowner, end up being the one that pays for it. One tactic I've seen is I had a company approach me years ago and they said, hey, we can do your credit card financing, and if we do it for you, we're gonna pay you. We're gonna give you money or points or whatever the program is that you will be you'll get a kickback for using us. And as I pried more into it and tried to figure out exactly what they were doing, I found out that they were charging the homeowner or the person on the end of all this a 4% fee. They were keeping 3% of it for their profit and paying for the credit card fees themselves. And then they were taking the last 1% or 0.8% or whatever, however the math works out, but they were taking that last little chunk and paying the contractor. And again, it's the homeowner that ends up paying for that. I'm not a big fan of that because it's just not very honest. I know there's states out there that are not okay. They've made laws where they make it to where service professionals cannot build processing fees or any kind of fees back towards the customer based on how they pay. So they have no choice. They have to build it into their pricing. I've just always had a problem with that. And here's why. If, let's say it's $500 to do the job and the contractor has to charge, you know, $510 to pay for those extra fees or whatever, so they have to raise their price to $510. So now, even if you pay cash or credit card or some sort of app that they're coming out with these days, things that there are no fees back to the contractor, you're now paying that extra chunk that you shouldn't have to pay for, if that makes sense, just because others are paying by credit card or loan fees or whatever. And so as we dig into this further, I touched on that video that I just referenced where someone was scammed because the contractor was able to build in not just fees, but they were basically overcharging this customer. They were able to hide money into the loan. So they said, well, it's either going to be 10 grand to do your job, or it's going to be $250 a month. Which one sounds better to you? And then when you do the math, the $250 a month for so many months ends up being way more. And where's that money going? I have no idea. It's either going in the contractor's pocket or the loan company or whoever, but it's you, the homeowner, that ends up paying for it. So how do you avoid that? Again, you get their best price, you get a couple quotes, and you get the best price you can, and then you go to our website, New HVAC Guide, scroll to the bottom, and get financing through us. The contractor can't hide anything on you at that point. Everything's up front. Everything is transparent. So I would say that's a red flag. If you have somebody come in your home, that's something that we don't do at Griffin Air. If they come into your house and they try to sell you a system based on a monthly payment, almost like you're trying to buy a used car, that's a red flag to me. And it should be a red flag to you. So instead of saying, hey, here's our price to do the job, here's our flat rate or turnkey price, here's, you know, we're going to charge you 10 grand to do this work. Instead, they're going to give you a monthly payment. And then once you do the math, it ends up being way more than that. And now we're seeing all kinds of new things on the market. We're seeing companies do things like leasing or rent to own or all these other weird programs. And there's always some sort of catch. There's some sort of in and out. It's either not actually owned by you, even though it's connected to your house, or some other weird program. Here's how you avoid all that. And I'm gonna say it one last time. Get some quotes, get your best price, find out the best system, and then go to our website and avoid all of that. They can't pull any funny business on you because it's all done through us and you won't have to worry about it. So you just, again, go to newhvacguide.com, scroll to the bottom, click financing, and they're gonna shop it around. You're gonna get a few different options. You can't get scammed at that point. You won't get scammed by the contractor. All that said, if you're in the market for a heating and air system and you're not in Virginia, go to my website, New HVAC Guide. Getting access to the guide, it's almost as if I wrote a book, but instead of a book that would become outdated, this website can be added to as new technology comes out. We've put all kinds of trade secrets on there. Some things contractors don't even want you to know. Some things heating and air manufacturers don't even want you to know. I've got a whole page called No-Nos. I've got a page for the heating and air brands and who's good and who's not. Definitely check out that website before you spend thousands. And if you are in our coverage area, if you're in Virginia, in the Northern Neck, Middle Peninsula, or Williamsburg, give us a call. We'll give you the best warranty in the area, and we'll give you a free estimate for a new heating and air system. Thanks for watching. Hope that helps. Click that subscribe button. We'll see you next time.